Hey my friends, welcome back. Yeah, as you can see in today's video, I'm gonna show you the secrets of how to paint a realistic fire / candle. So this is the pre-sketch, as you can see, and really very important is that you kind of delete the pencil marks, at least on the very bright parts, otherwise the color will not cover enough the black lines. So really delete those lines as best as possible. Yeah, then we grab a set of brushes. You can see here, soft ones, the main thing, size and shapes, up to you, what you prefer. And then we, kind of gonna use these five colors here, titanium white, lemon yellow, raw sienna, cat red, and lamp black to kind of mix a very simple palette. As you can see here, therefore speed it up more or less. Just getting darker. And then I oil out the painting surface. As you can see here, to prevent the color from getting sucked into this HDF plate. And then we start with the brightest area, the flame itself. You see it's a hint of a yellow to it on the lower end. But in the upper end we have just nearly pure and raw titanium white. This object kind of needs to be really brighter than the rest. You see, I'm mixing the colors while I'm going, and I'm then kind of yellowing out the lower end of the flame around the wick, as you can see here. And this little bit here is still part of the flame. And then we go darker. Remember, the rest of the painting needs to be darker than the flame. Therefore, I'm kind of mixing while I'm going, and I have a little darker yellowish color here now here to kind of show the viewer the flame and the part of the candle itself that we have behind the flame, more or less. The wick itself is not black, it's a bit reddish and a bit has some extensions to it. You can see here. And the brightest part is kind of glowing, as you can see here. The center part of it. And I'm applying the rest of color here. This area. Oh, and by the way, this video here is available as a full-time, real-time tutorial on my Patreon. Over 4 hours of pure in-detail painting. Make sure you check it out. Link is somewhere down below here. Yeah, as you see, I'm kind of slowly building up the volume of this candle here. Sorry, got a bit of a cold going on. And we... the more we kind of step away from the fire, the more the areas are not lit by the fire itself, the darker, the more reddish they need to become. And it's a quite tedious process, kind of, to kind of slowly build up those areas. This here, star color, is kind of a window that I'm gonna poke into the wick, into the candle itself. And we have a very black deck, very dark black background, and therefore, but the area around the candle itself is, on the fire itself, is a bit more reddish. That's what I apply here now. And I'm also mixing colors while I'm going to get darker, to get this reddish color to kind of blend into the very dark color that we have in the back. Without this, the candle fire would look off and wrong, just not right. It needs to have this kind of a shiny area around it. This you need to put it in to make it look just realistic. And here I'm gonna poke another hole into the Kendall in Serbia here. And also note that this color here is now darker. It's now more towards the color that we're gonna use later on. This, yeah, nearly kind of blackish color with a hint of red to it, more or less. And we also, yeah, add some more highlights to the areas that we, yeah, worked on before. They are still wet, keep this in mind. And to be able to do this, you need to, keep the color very thin. I mean, of course, you need to cover the white of the canvas, but don't apply a huge blob of color. Very important. A bit further down the road, we have the outer part. And you see, I'm getting slightly darker and colder as well. It's basically the outer part of the candle, more or less. See, it requires this lighter upper part color. I'm getting darker a tiny bit on this part that follows. And I'm also trying to build up this bubbliness, this roundness. just this red color. Slight red color is not enough. You need to really also build up the volume on these areas. You also want to have those little highlights, those little things that are lit by the fire itself. Same goes for this area here. Basically just putting them on roughly and then blending them in, kind of, so we have very soft, nice transition between those areas. Yeah, and you see now here how I'm building up the candle itself. And we have this, kind of structure showing through on the upper part, left side here, as you can see here. Those fine lines, and I try to repeat them on this area as well. So I put the color in, then grab a larger brush and start to fine blend. But I'm trying to also use the hair of the brush to show the structure of the candle. It's a process that took quite a while to kind of fine blend. I think it came out really nice. This pulled structure from the candle, more or less. These fine lines, more or less. And then comes a satisfying moment when we apply this very dark. It's not pure dark, see, palette here. Still containing some red. With this color we kind of build up the outer line of the candle. And also don't forget to kind of build up the volume again. You see I'm kind of blending into the very dark color we applied just now to make this candle bubbly, to make it look 3D. And this is kind of a very small detail here, but it's needed to make this thing really, I mean, no painting is perfect, but I'm trying to do it as best as possible. Kind of this next candle here is not as detailed, not as detailed painted as the one before, and the edges are also a bit more blended. With this dimple effect you achieve kind of a depth to this whole thing. I'm kind of pushing the candle in the back, more to the back, so that we have a really trompe-l'oeil 3D effect coming in. And I really think it's pretty clearly visible now, already here in this stage here. Less details, a bit more blurry edges, and this thing really, kind of starts to look realistic. I then decided to put in some more candles in the back, kind of freestyle, without any reference. But again, just follow the base idea of the light coming in. Therefore, we need to have this shadow here now, the very dark one. Also, kind of adding in those blue colors here from the candle that just died, kind of. And then I'm starting to build up, kind of really put the color into the still wet background to paint the just died, faded out candle, more or less. Moving the brush around, you will see it in our next scene a bit better. They also had some more of this, another dying candle thing here, but just blend the color into the still wet background. It's a very fine pointy brush, and try to be random, try to, if you don't know how this looks, get some reference, for example on pixels.com. It needs to have this edginess, kind of, and it also needs to fade out into the color we applied before, this dark one, bit better in detail, basically starting to put in the bluish, whitish color and really twist and twiggle and wiggle the brush around. And see, it took 5 seconds and we have a now a realistic looking candle painting. So that's about it for today. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, that like button, and see you next time. Bye.